So here we're going to look at using a calculator as efficiently as possible during any sort of GCSE question. And the various tricks are to use templates as much as possible. If you look at the, particularly at the row of black keys just under the option and calc, you'll see a fraction template, a square root template, x squared, a power template, and so on and so forth. We're also going to use brackets when we need to, especially if we come across negative numbers or perhaps standard form or something like that. And my tip is always just to try and get your question into a form where you do just one calculation. If you need it, the answer button, the ANS button, recalls the last answer. It's a sort of immediate memory. How do you do standard form? Well, you need the time 10 to the X button, which is at the bottom in the middle. Looks a bit odd when you do it, but it is right. And at some point later, we'll look at how to use the table function and get our calculator back into ordinary mode. And the real key here is to do as many questions as possible. Right, let's do a few. First of all, we want to use our calculator to work out this. And you just type it in. So, the biggest template there is a fraction. That's just below the option key. We want a square root on top. You see it's flashing on the top, so that's where we're going to write. So hit square root, and then 4.69. Okay, that's all under the square root. Go down to the bottom using the down cursor arrow, or cursor key. And on the bottom, we need to write 0.34 cubed. Now, you'll notice in small writing above the x squared, there is x cubed. So we do shift x squared, that makes it cubed, and then plus sine. Now you'll notice that that opens a bracket. We don't need to put the degree sign in, so sine 45, close the bracket, make sure you're still under the dividing sign there, the fraction sign, and press equals. And it says typically, write down all the numbers on your display. So here we go, 2.901406085. Don't worry about whether your calculator has more numbers or fewer numbers than other people's. It'll the examiner will know what to do. Right, have a look at the second question here. We're going to press clear. AEC means all clear, so clear everything. Now we've got a formula. So a little bit of work to do first. A to the 5 is p plus q over p squared q, and we want to find the value of a. So let's put the numbers in. A to the 5 is 1.2 times 10 to the minus 4 plus 7.83 times 10 to the 5 all over 1.2 times 10 to the minus 4 squared, so I'm putting that in a bracket to show that I'm squaring all of it, and times, and I'm going to put this in a bracket just to be safe as well, 7.83 times 10 to the 5. Actually, I don't need that in a bracket, but I will put it there. And then I want to find the fifth root of all of that. So I can take the fifth root of all of that, which, of course, if I do that on the left-hand side, will just give me a. So I'm now going to type in all of this in one go into my calculator. You might be tempted to do it in several goes, but it is actually easier to do it in one go. So the biggest template I need is the fifth root. Now above the x to the power of button, there is a root button. Okay, so I do shift x to the power of, and I get a little flashing number where I put the 5. So this will find the fifth root of whatever else I put in there. I'm going to use an arrow key, the right arrow key, to get inside it. And now I need a fraction. And I just start typing 1.2 times 10 to the power of minus 4. Now that's where it looks a little bit odd. Okay, but it does work. So plus, oops, just one plus, delete therefore, and 7.83 times 10 to the power of 5. Again, it looks a little odd, but that is right. Go down to the bottom, and I get, and I'm going to put this in a bracket, 1.2 times times 10 to the power of minus 4, close the bracket, x squared. And then times, and although I don't really need this bracket, I'll put it in because it looks good, 7.83 times 10 to the power of 5, close the bracket. Now, if you're not sure you've done it right, you can use your arrow keys to move around it to have a look. It all looks fine to me. And so I'm now going to press equals, and that will give me an answer. And I get 37.01071725. But I've been asked for it to three decimal places. So what do? I look at the fourth. It's five or more, and so I round the previous one up. So I get 37.011. Right, all clear again. And the final question, and this is on tables. Now, to access the table thing, you need to go to menu, which is top right there nearly. And somewhere here will be a table thing. On your calculator, it might be different. If I scroll down a couple of times, I get to number 9, table. So press 9, and it says f of x equals. And that's the y equals that you've got here. So you just type in the right-hand side here. Now, where do you get the x from? If you look at the close bracket key in red above that is an x. So you use the alpha button, which has red above it, to get the x. And then you just use the template. So shift x cubed. There we go. That's the x squared button. With a shift gives me x cubed. Minus 6. Again, alpha close bracket gives me the x plus 1. And I'm done. So I press equals. Now it asks me for a table range. Okay, and you can see that the range goes from minus 3 to 3. So minus 3 equals 3 equals. And the step, well, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, that's all in steps of 1. So I just put 1 in there and press equals. The default number is 1 there. And then having done that, I press equals and it gives me a table. And you can see the values of x in the left-hand column and f of x in the right-hand column. So minus 3 says minus 8. Minus 2 says 5. That's a good check that I'm doing it right. So I've ticked that. Minus 1 gives me 6. 0 gives me 1. Well, where are the other numbers? Well, I need to scroll down using the down arrow. And you can see there they are. X is 1. F of x or y is minus 4. F of x is 2 gives me y equals minus 3. And finally, x is 3 gives me y equals 10, which is good because that's what it's given me there. And I've done that. You might then be asked to plot a graph or something, but we're not going to. We just need to get out of our table function or our table operation, and we do menu, and usually 1 gets me straight back into calculating mode. So lots of practice at using your calculator, and you will get the hang of it.